Welcome back to another DeBacco University video. Today we have one on mitochondrial DNA and its use in forensic science. So while we know DNA, or the vast majority of our DNA, is stored in the nucleus, we also have some in the mitochondria. So how does that play into use in forensics, and where may that be useful looking at a crime scene? So first off, mitochondrial DNA, just the basics. Mitochondria does have some unique DNA sequences to it. And what's important to make note of is that all of these genes come only from your mother. A single mitochondria contains several loops of DNA. We can see that here. And this is in addition to the genes we have located, of course, in the nucleus. Mitochondria are found in all human cells, and they provide 90% of the energy that our body needs to function. Each cell in our body contains hundreds or thousands of mitochondria. So if you think about like a muscle cell, it's going to be very high energy demanding. That is more likely to have a greater number of mitochondria than, say, a skin cell. So when is mitochondria used in forensics? Well, nuclear DNA, if that has been significantly degraded, this is where we could maybe look at finding and sequencing and looking at mitochondrial DNA. Also, if the nuclear DNA is present in small quantities, that would lead us to go to the mitochondrial route, where authorities can obtain a reference sample from an individual who's long deceased or missing. These are conditions where the mitochondrial DNA might come into play. Now, is mitochondrial DNA, the fingerprints associated with that? Well, there's situations where authorities cannot simply obtain a reference sample from a missing child. A mitochondrial DNA reference sample is obtained from maternally related relatives. Remember, only the mom's side. The mitochondrial DNA can be amplified using a PCR, polymerase chain reaction. And what that's going to tell us is kind of an indication of, is there a possibility of having a match there? Because remember, nuclear DNA is inherited from all the ancestors and kind of passed down. Mitochondrial DNA is inherited in a single lineage, looking only at a person's maternal or mother line. So while it is a little limiting, it can be used, it can be useful, especially if the entire genome is in some way degraded or missing. This is another link we can use to further show the power of DNA associated with crime scenes.